gentlemen, welcome to some fun crocodile farm in Sydney. In a few moments, you'll enjoy the exciting spectacle, elephants in Thai history. For the first time in Thailand, you will have a glimpse of a close relationship that has existed over the centuries between the Thai nation and the elephant. A close relationship that has continued right up to the present day. A very gentle animal. Elephants found in Thailand are dark grey or greyish brown in colour, and average about 9 feet in height. That long trunk functions as an arm, as well as a nose. And those fearsome looking tusks, randomly sought by traders in ivory until recently when steps were taken to protect the animals, can be used either to pull up tree roots or viciously stab an enemy. The elephant's tremendous size gives the impression it is a slow and cumbersome animal. Well, looks can be deceiving. Elephants are relatively agile and able to move about the jungles with ease, nimbly negotiating winding pathways that inspires fear among the forest dwellers. Because of their great strength, intelligence, and willingness, elephants have always been used in Asia as work animals. They are adept in lifting or carrying heavy burdens, such as timber. Thai history without mentioning the mighty elephant, which fought side by side with the kings of ancient Siam. If it weren't for these noble beasts who carried our kings and warriors into battle, Thailand may not have sustained its status as the land of the free. The rare and highly prized white elephants, actually albinos, have always been the favorite because they symbolize the monarchy. Since ancient times, all white elephants found in Thailand become the property of the king. The discovery of a white elephant is considered an auspicious omen for the whole country. Several Thai monarchs have even been honored with the title King of the White Elephant. The majestic figure of a white elephant on a red background was the emblem of the Thai kingdom until the early 1900s. And even now, the Royal Thai Navy tricolour has a white elephant prominently depicted in the centre. The highest honour the king can bestow upon an individual is the Order of the White Elephant. Until recently, elephants were captured in the wild. Since elephants were much used in warfare, Thai kings were well versed in their hunting, training, and care. King Narai's extensive knowledge of elephants was even recorded in a contemporary 17th century chronicle of the Ayutthaya Kingdom. The protection of wildlife now prohibits this activity. The advance of civilization, too, has destroyed much forest land, the habitat of these wonderful animals. We are now about to take part in an elephant hunt. Directing the elephants are members of the Sui tribe, all natives of Sirin province in northeastern Thailand. Ancestors ancestors were renowned elephant hunters, having migrated from the province of Champasak in the Lao People's Democratic Republic. Other hunters lead at least 10 elephants to the same spot. The more elephants, the better. In the forest, all is calm and peaceful, with only the usual sounds of the jungle. Crickets break the silence with their strident calls. Men stealthily scatter in a circular herd. The horn champ requires that the wild elephants be captured right there in the clearing. Soon the tasks become a real art. To this day, the Forest Industry Organization trains elephant calves at a special camp in the north of Thailand. Thank you.
traditional thread of warfare is still a spectacle to be relived and marveled over. From that day onwards, no Asian warriors have gone to battle on elephant back. No longer do the banners of feathers flutter in the wind. No longer do the heads of nations face each other in direct combat. But here, at the San Juan Crocodile Farm, you can recapture the pomp and splendor of an ancient era when man and beast rode into battle. An era that today recalls the rich historical background that helped weave the tapestry of Thailand's glorious past. Crocodile Farm, thank you very much for your visit.